As the last contribution today, I want to read some remarks by Vint Cerf, Vice President and Chief Internet Evangelist at Google, who could not be with us. His comments nicely summarize some of the themes we've heard today. On the occasion of the 40th anniversary of Doug Engelbart's monumental demonstration of the online system in 1968, it seems appropriate to look back over the past 40 years and to try to look at least a little ways forward. I was a graduate student at UCLA at the time that Engelbart was pursuing his ideas for the augmentation of human intellect. He saw in the computer a tool that went far beyond its conventional use for computation. In this, he shared a vision with another pioneer, J.C.R. Licklider, who was funding Engelbart's work through the Information Processing Techniques Office at ARPA. That Licklider not only understood, but shared Engelbart's aspirations credits both of them with a remarkable prescience. Engelbart was able to convey his ideas and his excitement sufficiently well to draw an extraordinary team together to realize at least part of the dream with the relatively limited tools then available. Elsewhere, the chronicles of the NLS system have been sufficiently rendered that I won't attempt to do that in this brief note. The mouse, the five-finger keyboard, the portrait mode display, the black-on-white presentation, hyperlinking, hierarchical text manipulation, well, the list seems almost endless. Nor did Engelbart's vision end there. This was only the beginning. Looking back at the demonstration of NLS reminds us that much of what was shown persists today in the tools we use for knowledge work. It also reminds us that the vision vastly exceeded his ability then and our ability now to realize more than a fraction of it. Indeed, so extensive were his thoughts then and now that it is still hard to grasp their scope and import. Even though 1.5 billion people are on the internet using the World Wide Web, we can see that the tools and methods that Engelbart sought to bring into being are still beyond what has been implemented. NLS allowed document editors to grasp and manipulate text objects in ways that exceed the present HTML and XTML and XML encoded objects of the World Wide Web. While the web has grown in dimensions not instantiated in the NLS, for example, the incorporation of executable code in the form of Java or JavaScript inside documents, it's still fair to say that the ability of NLS to extract and manipulate portions of reference documents significantly exceeds the present expressiveness available in the web's world of information. If anyone is looking for directions in which to head in the next 40 years, one has only to view that long ago demonstration to realize how far we have come and how far we still have to go before we can claim to have climbed Engelbart's magic mountain. It is given to few generations to know such far-seeking prophets. It has been a privilege to know and appreciate Engelbart's rare gift of vision that he shared freely so that the rest of us might see. And now I'd like to invite Doug to come out and say a few words. Step up to the microphone. It's on.
Daughter says for me to say thank you. It seems inadequate, but thank you, thank you. This was just marvelous.
Thank you very much. Thanks for coming. So our program this afternoon is over. I'd like to finish by thanking all of our speakers. They did a terrific job. I'd also like to remind you to thank our sponsors, the MediaX program here at Stanford and the gracious loan of this auditorium, Logitech, of course, IBM, the Doug Engelbart Institute, Churchill Club, and the Computer History Museum. And speaking of the Computer History Museum, I'd like to remind you that there's a new exhibit under development called Computing History, the First 2,000 Years, the story of the technology, people, companies, and impact of one of mankind's greatest inventions. I'd also like to remind you that the Computer History Museum now has regular visiting hours and that admission is free. So I'd like to thank all of you for your patience this afternoon, and for those of you who'd like shuttles back to the Galvez parking lot, they're out at the corner of Galvez and Sarah Streets. And many thanks again for coming. Thank you.